The third element we're going to show in terms of set-based programming, and we've just shown loading and deduplication, is transformation. I don't know how many of you have actually ever tried to do a bulk update on 10 million rows or a bulk delete on 10 million rows and realized that it took a long time to run. And then you type Control C and then you found you had to wait even longer while it recovered. And for that period of time, the data was offline and nothing was getting done. And at the end of the day, you probably still never even got your transformation done, your bulk update. So in reality is when we get to large data sets, the buffer cache becomes the problem itself. You can't afford to cache all the data, modify all the data in memory inside the buffer cache, and then write it all back as well as the associated undo and redo. The challenge we get on this whole problem is that the buffer cache just cannot push enough blocks through fast enough, and the overhead, the CPU cost of just manipulating blocks into the buffer cache and back out again, one block at a time, usually an 8K block at a time, means that the database writer is working really hard and the user processes are working really hard just to get the volume of buffers through. So again, for manipulating data, we need to start thinking about transformation techniques that basically redefine the object rather than modify the object in place. So if I was to think about if you were to write a query to redefine the data how you would like to see it in the future and then direct it into a table, and then you were to change the table names at the end, it would take a lot less time than if you wanted to manipulate all the data in place and then fit as an update or a delete statement or a merge statement. We're going to save a lot of time and effort and redo and undo and all those sort of things. And you're going to be able to take advantage of core database parallelism techniques, bulk I/O techniques such that we read a megabyte and we write a megabyte in and out at a time rather than 8K at a time. We can get huge efficiencies in terms of manipulating data. And this becomes extremely important as the data sets get bigger and bigger. And as the data sets get bigger and bigger, it may be the only way that you can have effectively manipulate the data in real time. So again, we're going to do a similar thing as what we did. We're going to run a race and we're going to do 101 million rows, and what we're going to do is transform some data. And one of those things, I'm going to just start up the race and then we're going to talk through how the code looked and how it was done. Again, all the hardware is identical, but the thing is just to notice that we've coded it different ways and we're getting a measure of how the performance works. So in this case, you can see the set-based technique, and this is why this session is on set-based programming, is way in advance of everybody else. But again, you can see that the row by row and the array processing is only using one CPU, whereas the homegrown parallelism and the set-based processing is using a lot of CPUs. And you can see that likewise, the set-based technique has finished way in advance of everybody else. Let's just recap the times. 26 seconds to manipulate 101 million rows. 1 minute 52 seconds for the homegrown programming parallelism, 11 minutes for the array interface, and 5 hours for one row at a time. This is a dramatic way difference in performance. Again, 5 hours to 26 seconds as a means of manipulating data. Let's just go have a look at the code again. If we look at the row by row programming techniques, you can see that we've got a cursor loop, and we're looping through the data, applying conditional logic, modifying the data, and then writing it out to potentially two tables. Again, you can see that a lot of code being written, processing is done by the row, one row at a time, and that's how it's working. Well, I won't show you too much detail on the other two because I'm sure you can guess what we've done on Racer 2. We've used bulk operators to put and get the data, grab the data as a fetch case out of the data. We've manipulated the data in a tight loop, one row at a time, and using bulk operators to write it back. With the manual parallelism, we've used that Aura hash function again to split the data up amongst 32 query slaves so we can get everything busy. The last one I'd like to show you really is the one we want to look at, and look at is the set-based programming. And again, you can see that the code is a lot easier. We're using the insert technique, and we've got conditional logic associated where it goes on. But again, what we're starting to do is we know we're starting to build pipelines, okay? So you can see that we've used, in fact, the with clause here, all right, to define a SQL statement, okay, to define certain things from certain days. And we've also basically used, in this case, some conditional logic, i.e. a case statement, on the select list to figure out what codes we're going to be using to determine the next stage of the processing. And then the very simple thing is we're doing a transformation here, and you can see that we're basically using some outer join techniques, set-based techniques, and outer joins become an incredibly important thing to learn when manipulating sets of data, so we can see them being used here. And we're doing joins on this case to manipulate the data. So again, you can see we're starting to build a pipeline, and one of the easiest ways to build a pipeline that makes code that's readable is to use the with clause to have a SQL statement. Okay, and then we're basically using conditional logic on the select list, which would represent a lot of the code you would normally associate with a normal update statement, but it's being manipulated by a case statement on the select list. So you can see we're, again, the set-based programmer here is using a mixture of techniques to pipeline rows that would be handled by core parallelism through all phases of the transaction.